like, all relationships don't always lead to marriage. So if you don't want to be that test sample relationships here and there, you have to set boundaries for your relationships. Welcome to my channel. My name is Temi D. If you just see my face for the first time, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, press the notification bell so you can be notified when I post new videos. So today's video is about setting boundaries in relationships, and I'm actually talking about godly relationships. Like, all relationships don't always lead to marriage. So if you don't want to be that test sample relationships here and there, you have to set boundaries for your relationships so that that relationship, whether it ends bad or it ends good, you can leave that relationship confident, and not confident that you tried and you didn't get broken or get damaged. My first tip on how to set boundaries in relationships is, don't visit them at home if they live alone, right? For if they live with their parents, that's fine, you can go visit them. If they live with maybe a family member or a cousin or a relative, that's fine, you can go visit them. And even when they live with their parents or family and they have their own room and all that, if you say you want to go to their room to hang out, that's not setting boundaries, and something could happen because you guys are getting to know each other. Things happen. We are all human. We are all flesh. One thing might lead to another, and then you find out that you have in this relationship, you've slept with this guy, even though you don't even know where the relationship is going, but because you had feelings for him, you let your emotions get a better part of you, and you ended up falling into the temptation of fornication, which is aka sex before marriage. And if he doesn't end up proposing to you, then what happens next? It'll be like another person that you slept with that didn't end up in marriage. So one way to really, really keep your boundaries is not to visit them in their house when they're living alone, or not to go to their house all by yourself. The second way to set boundaries in relationships is, don't just feel that you are too strong, you are too spiritual. Oh, I can handle it. Oh, I have everything under control. I'm a born again Christian. I know what to do. Even if I'm alone with him, I know when to stop. I know when to stop. Maybe when you start kissing or hugging, I know when to draw the line. Some people have tried, some powerful men of God, they've tried and they failed. So the Bible says we should see all appearances of evil. So when things are looking like that, it's better to be safe than to be sorry. The Bible says to obey is better than sacrifice, because when you end up thinking that you're Superman or you are strong, remember Samson, that's how Samson was thinking he was Superman. He's strong, he can do anything, he can get to Delilah and he won't fall. And what happened? He fell. Samson, that was a strong man, Samson the strong man, fell. So who are you not to fall if you are exposed to such incidences that might lead to temptation? Don't try and think you have everything under control, because the flesh is weak, and anybody, trust me, anybody can fall into temptations. The mighty have fallen, not because they plan to fall, just because the flesh took over. My third way to set boundaries in relationship is, be strong for each other. And if you're in a relationship and you are dating with purpose, you are dating with marriage in view, you are dating to get married, you have to be strong for each other, because there are sometimes one is weak and then the other has to be strong. When the woman, for instance, is weak and the man is also weak, that is a recipe for disaster. The Bible says iron sharpens iron. If both of you are Christians and when one falls into temptation, the other is there to encourage the other is there to say, no, let's not do this. Let's be strong for each other. It's time to go back to your house or whatever. Maybe it's late, and maybe even if he's living with his parents and you come to the house and he's the only one at home, and something else, one thing leads to the another. It's the responsibility of one of the parties to be strong for the other by saying, no, 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 this has gone too far. If one person is weak, then the other person should be strong for the other person and encourage the other person and guide the other person, so both of you don't fall at the same time. The fourth way I have today for setting boundaries is, if you're going on the date, he wants to take you out for dinner to the restaurant, it's advisable to drive in separate vehicles and actually meet there. I know sometimes it's easy, oh, one person has the car, I can pick you up and all that, but that opens the door for things to happen, things that you didn't plan for. If you can help it at all, it's better for you guys to drive in separate cars and meet at the venue, and when it's time to go home, go back in your separate cars, especially when you're just getting to know each other. The relationship is not yet solid. You're just learning, getting to know who this guy is or who this girl is. Is he serious? What does he do? What are his plans? If you don't want to set boundaries, then you can do anything you want, right? But if you're dating with a purpose, with marriage in view, and you want to do it the godly way, these boundaries are for those who want to wait. A lot of people have wanted to wait, but due to one reason or the other, due to temptation, due to the strength of the flesh, they have not been able to wait. Some relationships have even broken up in the process of them not being able to wait. So my sixth way of setting boundaries is to hang out in groups. It's easier for, like, when you're dating a brother and you're hanging out in fellowships, you're hanging out as a group of singles groups, singles fellowships, singles retreats, singles get together. Like, if you guys want to go to the movies, go in groups. If you guys want to go for dinner, go in groups. That's an easy way. Everybody's having fun, everybody's chatting, everybody's gisting, and when it's time to go, everybody goes to their house. So that group outing prevents you guys from falling into temptation, because people are there to check on you, and you can't be doing stuff in front of other Christian brothers or other Christian sisters, because when they see you, they will correct you, like, hey sis, brother, what's going on? You guys are going too far. But if, for instance, if you're going for a bowling activity, organize other couples who are like-minded Christians like you guys. You guys can go bowling together. You guys can go to the movies together. You guys can do stuff together. So that way you can stay holy, you can stay righteous, and you can stay in line with God's plan for you, for your relationship, which is tending towards marriage. And don't forget, dating, courting is all about getting to know each other. It's all about discovering each other. It's not a time to discover each other's body parts. It's not a time to discover each other sexually. It's a time to discover each other's purpose, each other's calling, the plan of God for you guys. If you guys are aligned in terms of purpose, in terms of direction, in terms of spending eternity with each other, if you guys are not aligned, then that is a good time to find out. It's not a good time to start discovering how you guys are going to gel together in bed. No, that's not what dating in a Christian relationship is for. So my number seventh way to set boundaries in a Christian relationship is, do not move in together. Wait until you're married and then you guys can start living together. Some people might say, oh, I don't know him, I really want to know him. Let me tell you, even if you've lived together for 10 years before marriage, some relationships, they've lived with each other, got to know each other, and it still ended up in divorce. Yeah. And because you're dating, people are going to be at their best, really. But as soon as you get married, then you start to see some things that, you know, you they were probably hiding from you at the courting phase. What you see is what you get. If it's a genuine man of God or a genuine woman of God, they won't fake it. Some people have faked it, but if God is on your side, God will reveal that person. The Bible says we should test all spirits. If that person is a genuine child of God and you're courting, God will reveal the truth about that person to you. So when relationships break up, don't be too hard on yourself. It might just be that God has a better plan for you. It might just be that God revealed something to you that you could not live with. So it's better at that point to seek God's face so that you can find out what it is that this person, what it is in this person's nature or this person's character that is not in line with God's purpose for your life. It's very, very important at those dating stages to discover things like that instead of trying to discover your body parts. Alright guys, so that's all I have today about setting boundaries in relationships, in Christian relationships, heading towards marriage. If you want to get married, like for me, I really, really wanted to get married. That's one of the things I desired. I desired to be in a happy relationship. I prayed to God about it and God gave me that which I desired. The Bible says He will grant you the desires of your heart. When you desire something and you seek God's face and you obey Him, He will grant those desires of your heart. God will not provide you with the best if you're disobedient. What thing that God loves is obedience. God's love language is obedience. All right, my lovelies, my family, love you guys so much. Thank you guys for all my new subscribers. I love and appreciate you. If you are yet to subscribe, what are you waiting for? Please subscribe, please like, please share, please press the notification bell so you can be notified when I post new videos. All right guys, thanks for watching and see you in my next video. Bye. Thank you.